While delivering the State of Nation address at Kololo Ceremonial Grounds earlier this week, President Yoweri Museveni promised to meet all players in the coffee sector to discuss the fate of Uganda's coffee after Parliament passed a resolution to terminate the embattled agreement between the government of Uganda and Uganda Vich Coffee Company Limited of the Italian investor Enrico Pinetti.
She had no idea about coffee. It is not her. She had no idea about coffee. I, however, could see that she had a wide network of contacts. I asked her to look into coffee. After some time, she came back with a positive report that it was doable. I am the one who told her. She didn't. For her, she was in hospitals. Those attacking that project are supporters of Okenenura to bleed of Africa, perpetual bleeding. If they were not, they would have responded to our call of 1986 and after to come forward and add value to coffee and seek government assistance.
Although members of parliament welcome the president's move to consult stakeholders, they want the controversial agreement with Vinci Coffee to be out of discussion since its fate was decided by parliament.
We want to see the whole process. How do we add value to our coffee? How do we ensure that we earn what we deserve from our coffee product? And what needs to be done? That is not Vinci consultation. If you are consulting about Vince and the agreement by the findings of Parliament is that that agreement was dead ab initio, enforceable, unenforceable, and unconstitutional. So there is no consultation on a dead thing.
That the people in Uganda currently are working hard to earn the little that they are earning, and others are not getting anything. It is only through such cash crops like coffee that our communities are surviving. Anything that is for trial, anything that is not very well researched on, anything that can be talked about handing over to somebody who doesn't know, somebody who doesn't have the skill, somebody who has not participated in this very important cash crop, it is making a suicidal attempt to the livelihood of our people.
Although they represent Ugandans in parliament, MPs have asked the president to take the consultation to grassroots and interact with farmers, cooperatives, processors, and other key stakeholders in the business, using the same model he's currently using on his tour in the Greater North instead of consulting leaders alone.
But in actual sense, if he's supposed to meet the coffee farmers, they are people, because these are organizing. For example, we have cooperative unions and cooperative societies. If we can meet the leaders of the cooperative unions and cooperative societies, for example, Bugisu Cooperative Society Union, for example, East Mengo Growers Cooperative Union, Banyankore Kweterana, Buruli Cooperative Union, and many others, I think those people have the gist of the matter. They can come and explain and give the president a proper picture how coffee can be handled in this country.
Just picking an idea from someone or pushing one individual against the interests of many, that was wrong. But in the event that is now going to pick consultations from the stakeholders, that is absolutely right.
Prior his meeting of farmers at a regional level, then they should first hold what we call mini discussions. Farmers themselves should hold mini discussions where they have to iron out issues which concern with the coffee before they meet at the regional level.
Muhammad Muwanga Chivumbi, the chairperson of Buganda Parliamentary Caucus, has urged the president to consider consulting Buganda Parliamentary Caucus since coffee is mainly grown in the central region.
Coming up to say we are consulting about coffee, then you need to consult with some chairperson of Buganda Caucus, the biggest growing region in the country. And our representatives, those who come from coffee growing, about how do we add value and ensure that our coffee we get from what we deserve from coffee.
The team come to Uganda, meet the Uganda caucus. Nobody will refuse to meet him if the president is meeting Uganda caucus. And then we tell him what Uganda feels about him. That is massacre and greater massacre.
Whereas lawmakers agree with the president on the need to foster value addition in the coffee sector instead of exporting raw coffee, many are concerned that the government has not yet invested in coffee value addition facilities, yet stakeholders have also been take to.
We're not fighting value addition. We are fighting somebody that was in charge of health, roads, but is coming to the coffee sector. So he said it himself. That this Veneti was not doing it. I'm the one that interested in coming in these things. Why not interest fellow Ugandans?
On May 18th, 2022, Parliament passed a resolution directing the government to cancel the controversial coffee deal signed between the Minister of Finance and Enrique Pinetti of Uganda Vinch Coffee Company Limited after finding it unconstitutional. This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.